I think that idea of yours, Reb, about the kangaroo court, that should sort her out. Make her answer our charges. I'll be the judge and hand down the punishment, if she's guilty.
We don't need a trial to tell us that.
Are you with me or not?
Yeah, can you think of something better?
Yeah, I reckon it's a good one.
Oh. What do you think, Kelly?
I think it stinks, but I haven't got much choice, have I?
No.
Okay, girls, for the early night, some of you could use the beauty sleep.
Thank
back
you.
To yourselves, come on.
Yes, can't wait.
So what's it going to be?
Tomorrow night, sooner the better.
Do you see anything?
Nah, shadows. I can't make out who's who.
Careful of that stretcher. We don't want another accident.
Not a bloody clue. There's a mob of them, though.
Don't make a bloke feel very welcome, Mrs. Reynolds.
Please. I don't know why you're doing this, but don't hurt Meg. She's the baddest.
Bull. She's another bloody screw. She might come in handy later. Okay, ladies. We're going on a little trip. Keep going along here till I tell you.
Where are you taking us?
Oh, nice place. You'll like it. I went to a lot of trouble to get it ready.
How long do you think it'll take the police to find you after what you've just done?
Long enough. Used to plan how me and Phyllis and Mum would get away after I got out. Used to keep me going in there thinking about that. I pulled one last monster job. Taking the money and gone bush. We could have been happy. Get out a couple of months ago and what do I find? What do I find? What do you think's the first thing Mum had to tell me when I got out, eh?
I don't know.
The hell you don't! Phyllis is a bloody vegetable, that's what! I wasn't sure how to get you back, not at first. Those letters, just a warm-up. Just to give me time to think. After that first cop got killed, after you made me do that, didn't matter much what I did from then on. I can kill anyone I like now, free of charge. You know anyone else who can say that?
Hey, you wanted to kill us? Why didn't you do it back at the flat? Why go to all this trouble?
I said I could kill you if I wanted to. I didn't say I was going to. It's all up to your precious department, isn't it?
How do you mean?
Well, it depends how much they think you're worth. And you'd better hope it's plenty. Pull over up here. We have to walk.
Well, I don't think it's a good idea bringing them here. It's just asking for trouble.
Don't worry, I know their type. I've handled that sort before.
But what's going to happen when the women find out? I mean, we can't keep it a secret from them forever. Staff room, Joyce Barry.
Joyce, it's Phil.
Yeah.
Look, I've been trying to get onto Meg and there's no answer at her place. I thought maybe she and Anne had come over there for some reason.
No, but it's strange that there's no one answering. I mean, aren't they supposed to have a policewoman in the flat with them?
Yeah, I don't know what to make of it. Look, there's probably a simple explanation, but look, just the same, I think I'll run over there and check that everything's all right.
Right, well, I'll phone Inspector Rouse just in case he's decided to move them somewhere else.
Okay, thanks, Joyce.
Good night.
Any luck?
No, she's had more than enough time to get there.
Well, mate, you don't know she's gone straight home. She could have stopped off somewhere.
But there should still be someone at the flat. Look, how about driving me over there?
Okay.
Gee, it's really quiet in here.
Yeah, it's always quiet at night.
Yeah, but this quiet?
Come on, now, don't start imagining things.
Jude, what's going to happen at this trial tomorrow? Well, I mean, it's not going to get out of hand, is it? Turn into a riot or something? Well, what happens if someone gets hurt?
No one's going to get hurt, love. That's the whole idea of it.
Yeah, but it wouldn't take much. I mean, once they all get together and start raking over all the things Sarah's done to them, I reckon they'll get pretty worked up.
Come on, love. It's going to be okay. It's just a bit of fun. Myra will keep everything in control.
Sure.
I'm positive. Go to sleep.
Hey, they're going to need an artist.
What?
A courtroom artist to draw what happens.
Yeah, come to think of it, Myra was talking about getting one of those people today.
All right, don't send me up.
I'm not sending you up. Take her load off her mind to know she's got one of those.
Okay, I get the message.
Good, now, good night.
Do you think we'll find out tomorrow who that new prisoner is?
I don't know. Judging from the amount of heavies out there, it's someone pretty important. Real big potatoes.
Oh, God. What the hell's going on? What the hell's going on?
Three police officers are dead, that's what.
Meg, what's happened to Meg?
There's no sign of her or Mrs. Reynolds. We have to assume he's taken them with him.
But you're supposed to...
Take it easy. Yes, I'm sorry. Three of my people are dead. I'm sorry about that, too.
What are you doing to find them?
Everything we can. Listen, I don't believe he intends to kill them. Certainly not immediately.
And what the hell do you mean by that?
If he wanted to kill them, he'd have shot them on the spot. My guess is he wants something. He's keeping them as hostages. So I'd say we'd be hearing from him pretty bloody soon. Okay?
We hadn't had that argument.
There's no need. You know you couldn't have done anything about it, all right?
Open. You heard what I said? Open. Not that it matters much anyway. You could scream your head off in this place. No one would ever hear. Just don't want you to be too comfortable. That's all.
You're mad if you think you can get away with this.
No, screw. Phyllis is mad. That's what this is all about. You did it to her. Your turn, sweetheart. Come on. Open up. Come on. Good girl. Right, ladies. I'm going to leave you now. And in case you get to thinking about wandering around when I'm gone, the whole place is packed with plastic explosive. Enough to blow away half the block. If anything sets it off. When I walk out this door, ladies, I'll connect the battery. There are trip wires everywhere, ladies. So be careful. A little word of advice. If you do set it off, get your hands over your ears real fast. You think I'm bluffing? You figure I need hostages so I won't kill you? Don't believe it. I've got plans, all right, but if you two blow yourselves off the face of the earth, guess I'll just have to change them. I reckon it'd be almost worth it. Night-night, ladies. If you're still in one piece in the morning, I'll see you then.
Rotten way to start off your working day, but that's how it is.
What sort of a mongrel is this plan?
The worst sort. That's why I need all the help I can get from you people. Any ideas at all you might have?
I think I should mention the department has a special concern in this matter. We had a call earlier today demanding $250,000 ransom.
You mean up until that point the department wasn't concerned?
Well, no, of course that's not what I mean.
Well, if you've had a ransom call, that's a good sign they're still alive, isn't it?
Yes, it is. We're expecting a series of calls from him. So we put a tracer machine on all the likely phone lines. That includes your ones here at Wentworth.
Yeah, of course, the department is trying to keep all this out of the press. In the interest of the safety of the two women involved.
Yes, it'd be a good idea if the women weren't told either. They'd only use it as a chance to cause trouble. And we're understaffed quite enough as it is.
I hardly think this is the time to talk about staffing levels. However, I agree about the prisoners. Every effort should be made to keep it from them.
Well, we can stop the newspapers and take away the TV and radios until further notice.
Good. Well, that's all for the moment, I think. Oh, good Lord, no. Of course, I have to put someone in the chair, don't I? Can't leave the place without a governor.
Well, I'd be happy to help in any way I can, sir.
And me?
I have already given the matter consideration. And until this matter is resolved, it is the department's decision to appoint Mrs. Barry to the position. If that's agreeable to you, Mrs. Barry?
Oh, yes, Mr. Colby. Thank you.
Good. Then that's all settled. Now, we have a long and difficult day ahead of us. I think we should all get on with it.
G'day, ladies. Sorry I'm a bit late. I knew you'd wait, so I slept in. Yeah. You two behave yourselves. Undo your gag so you can have something to eat, eh? Then, you can take a little walk into the next room, eh? That's for Dunny. He says us Grimms aren't civilized, eh? Just so long as you realize this is a special privilege. Either of you, triumph and stupid, and you won't get untied again. And you won't get fed again.
You really like the sound of your own voice, don't you?
I'm just making sure you know the rules. Get going before I change my mind.
No feeling in my hands.
You've got nothing to complain about, have you?
You all right?
Are you going or not? Dumped your car, all right? Miles from here. Even if the cops do find it. I mean, they'll find you.
Why are you doing this? What do you hope to get out of it?
$250,000 for starters. But you never thought you were worth that much, eh?
Come on. When did you last hear of someone getting away with something like that? I mean, even a smart crim can't do that. What chance have you got?
One thing you've got to remember about me, ladies. I've got nothing to lose. Nothing. So you shut up. And if you're hungry, eat. As you won't get another chance.
You haven't had much to say for yourself today.
Tried to see the governor a while ago, see if she's found out anything about my parents. They wouldn't let me in. Said she's too busy.
Hey, I don't know what's going on, but there are cops all over the place out there.
Well, ask Mrs. M. She's on duty.
Are you sure? Because I haven't seen her.
Unless she's sick or something.
Hey, I've probably worked out what happened. It's Mrs. Morris in isolation. She got sick of her job and murdered the freak.
Hey, someone had a go at the freak. They didn't do a very good job because she's out there alive and kicking and looking pretty mad about something.
My God, you don't think they found out what we planned to do to Sarah Higgins tonight?
Nah, we'd know about it by now. Anyway, they wouldn't call the cops in for that. Bobby, you've been on skip duty. Did you get into the staff room?
Yeah, there's some guy from the department up there ordering everyone around as if he owns the joint. Mrs. Reynolds isn't there.
From the department?
Yeah, he's got it written all over him.
Must be about that new bot in isolation.
You know, they wouldn't even let us take food trays up there. The screws had to do it.
I think it's about time we found out, don't you?
How?
Well, send someone up to have a look. Someone with freedom of movement. Someone on cleaning duty, for instance.
Oh, me?
Want to give it a try?
Oh, all right. Oh, golly, I'll be able to do all those clever things that Minnie taught me. You know, picking locks, all those clever things.
I doubt whether you'll be picking those security locks.
Oh, of course I could. Minnie said I was her best student.
Okay, Pixie, give it a try, but be careful. The freak's on the prowl.
Right, I'm on my way. They've found the car. They're checking it for prints.
What good will that do? If they switch cars, I could be anywhere by now.
One man with two prisoners makes for some pretty awkward traveling. I don't think he'd take them any further than he had to.
How the hell do three people just disappear like that?
Very easily, I'm afraid.
So you're telling me you don't have any leads?
We have a specific line of inquiry we're pursuing.
Which is?
It's too soon to talk about it. I'm going to have a look at the car now. I'll be back later.
Look, I'll come with you.
No, you won't. Look, four people are dead already in this case.
Look, you're telling me I just have to stay here and do nothing?
Any developments, I'll let you know.
Did you get their radios too?
Of course. Wouldn't be getting them back if it was up to me. What happens on the outside's got nothing to do with this mob. Everything would be different if I was in charge.
Oh, come on. You surely didn't expect to be appointed AG. You've only been here 5 minutes.
It only takes me 5 minutes to find out what's going on in this place. It's easy to see why the department didn't pick you as governor. I heard on the grapevine what a nice mess you made of it last time.
I would be a damn sight better in that job than either you or Barry, and you know it.
Well, I'll be giving them my full support. But then again, that's where we differ, isn't it? I'm a pro.
Hardly worth taking these off, was it, eh? Hardly ate nothing either of you. Hurry up in there. I don't want you wandering around in here after I've gone, would we? What's the matter with you? Stupid bitch, I don't know what you did yet. You're gonna pay. You're gonna pay, bitches!
You can tell the minister I'll keep him informed.
Come in.
Any news?
My office will know where to contact me at any time.
Afraid not.
Excuse me, Mrs. Barry has more to do than hand out news bulletins. If there is any news, the staff will be advised at the appropriate time.
Look, I'm not after news bulletins. I'm here because I'm a friend of Mrs. Morris. A close friend.
I see. Well, the police are doing everything possible.
Look, are you going to pay the ransom or not?
I don't think I like your tone.
I don't give a damn what you like. Are you going to pay?
Well, if this is the sort of cooperation I can expect from the staff, I think we're in a lot of trouble.
Meg and Anne who are in trouble, and you don't seem to give a damn.
Well, of course I give a damn. But I have every confidence in the police. When this person rings again, there's every possibility the police will trace the call and catch him.
But what if they don't? Are you going to pay the money then?
Look, surely you people can see that if we give in now, we'll be the target of every crackpot in the state. We have to set an example.
And what kind of example are you setting for the rest of your staff? How does it feel, Joyce, knowing that if some psycho gets his hands on you, as far as your precious department is concerned, you're on your own?
Please, Philip, calm down. You're not achieving anything.
Help! Can you hear me? Oh.
Ferguson?
Yes, Miss Ferguson?
The hell do you think you're doing?
Oh, I'm cleaning.
Cleaning? You're cleaning the security gate. Is that what you're trying to tell me?
Yes. Gosh, it's dirty.
Well, Mason, perhaps you would like me to open it so you can clean the other side.
Oh, would you? Thank you.
Mason, if you're not out of here in 5 seconds, you'll be on a charge now. Move.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Anne, be careful. If he really has set tripwires, they'd be impossible to see in this light.
Oh, no, it's all right. I can see well enough.
Hey, Big deal. Hey, this will be. No one ever comes here. Come on, give us fags. Get knotted on first.
Two young boys.
Up here.
You hear that?
Help me. Yeah.
He said no one could see us. Hell, if me old man finds out.
Please.
Let's go, she's calling the cops.
Did they hear you? I don't know. We scared them, they've gone. Damn! They'll be back. Kids always love this sort of place.
Oh, no, just, we'll face it. It's hopeless. No one can help us now. If that maniac decides to kill us, there's nothing we can do.
Well, it's up to us, isn't it? Look at us!
I notice your lot haven't been snapping at my heels so much today. I suppose I've got you to thank for calling them off.
You're not off the hook yet. I'm working on it. And next time, don't push in.
Want to come look at the Bronx? We'll have a burst race tonight.
You don't give up, do you?
Oh, come on, it'd be good fun. What's wrong with it?
Well, there's not going to be any anyway. They only come out when it's raining.
Well, who says it's not going to be raining? Have you heard a weather report?
Where are we going to hear a weather report? They've taken away trannies, TV, newspapers. We may as well be in bloody Siberia for all we know. Hey, Mara, why do you reckon they did that?
Because they don't want us to find out who's in isolation, that's why. I mean, the freak wasn't very happy when she found Pixie up there.
Well, I've got a great idea. Why don't we run a book on
them?
Oh, come on, it must be someone we all know, otherwise they wouldn't be trying to keep it a secret. Who wants to lay back?
Give it a rest, Marlene.
Only trying to supply a bit of bloody entertainment, you'd die of boredom otherwise.
Okay, fair enough. We'll work it out for yourself. Now, Mrs. Morris and Mrs. Barry are supposed to be on duty today, right? But no one's seen them. London to a brick, they're up in isolation. Add that to all the police activity, and whoever is up there is somebody very important.
Yeah, well, you know, they won't let people in to see the governor either. Sam's been trying all morning.
Hasn't she seen her yet? Where is she now?
Second sitting. They kept telling her the governor's busy.
Yeah, we'll see about that. It's a violation of prisoners' rights, and they know it.
Still like to know he's in isolation, though. They'll have to let him out soon.
Yeah, don't bet on it. What about Helen Smart? Jude reckoned there was almost a riot to get her out of isolation just because she upset some bloody politician.
Hell yeah, it could be someone like that or someone important anyway. Edna Everett.
Oh, she bloody stupid.
Could be Erica Davidson, though. They reckon she disappeared pretty suddenly. What if she knows something the department don't want anyone to know, so they've locked her in isolation to keep her quiet?
Oh, you two stop carrying on.
Just because she was a department head, Sarah Higgins was a VJ, and they put her up there.
Mm. Yeah, I wish they kept her up there, too. She's been nothing but trouble since she came down here.
We might never find out.
Of course we will. Who wants to make a bet?
Look, as it turns out, it's just as well I was up there. Otherwise, Mason might have seen them, and that would have been the end of your little secret.
Well, there you are, then.
It doesn't alter the fact that I've been up there all morning, and I fail to see why I should be up there all afternoon as well.
Look, I've spoken to Mr. Colby about staff replacements, and he's promised to see who's available.
Oh, yeah. And how long's that going to take? I say they should be locked up, and that way they won't need as much supervision.
Those prisoners have been through enough already. I'm not going to punish them further, simply to make things more convenient for you.
The fact is, we are short-staffed. Now, when Cruikshank and Rogers left, we only got Murphy to replace them. Now, you're filling in for the governor. That leaves us two officers short.
I think it's best for the officers to do whatever is necessary to maintain the safety and well-being of the prisoners upstairs. I hope that's understood, Miss Ferguson. Now, is there anything else you wanted?
I think I'm getting somewhere. No, really. I can feel it getting looser.
Been at it for a long time.
And I'm not imagining it. You just give me a few more minutes.
What?
What's wrong?
Oh, I feel...
Meg! Meg!
Meg!
Governor's office?
Colby. His office, Tommy's there.
Who's calling, please?
Never mind that. I haven't got time. Just put him on.
I think it's him.
Colby. Colby, have you got the money yet?
Who am I talking to?
Never mind the garbage, Colby. Have you got the money or haven't you?
No, of course not. Well, not yet. You haven't exactly asked for small change.
If you haven't, they'll be dead, Colby. Is that what you want? Do you want them dead?
No, I don't.
Okay. I'll tell you how I want the money, Colby. I want it in small notes. And don't bother to mark it, okay?
How do I know that the women are still alive?
Because I said so.
No, that's not good enough.
Tough! You just have the money ready the next time I ring, okay?
No, I need to know that the women are still alive.
Look, if you don't stop talking like that, Colby, they won't be.
Look, if you want the money, I have to know that the women are alive. God, that only makes sense, doesn't it? A tape recording played over the phone will do.
Okay. You'll get your proof, all right? You just have the money ready when I call.
I'll see what can be arranged. How would you like the money handed over?
I told you! I'll call you, you bastard!
Damn. Do you think the police will be able to get a trace of it?
How do I know? I expect they'll let us know in time.
Yes?
I thought I should let you know there's reporters at the gate.
Reporters? Well, now the women will find out.
If we keep the women away from the reporters, there's no reason they should. All television, radio and newspapers have been stopped.
Oh, yes.
Can I suggest we stop phone calls and visitors as well? Only needs one of the inmates to get word and we'll be all over the prison.
Yes, I think we probably should.
I'll see to it right away.
That's good thinking.
Thank you, Mr. Colby.
Oh, bugger, what are we supposed to do without the telly?
Can't even have a game of softball. There's no point going on about it. All those things are privileges, not facts. The governor can cancel them any time she likes.
Yeah, well, I wish she'd bloody tell us why. What's going on in this place?
Hey, look what I found, the old radio.
Only because it hasn't worked for years.
Oh, we'll just get Bobby to fix it. After yesterday, she's our resident electrician. Come on, Sparky.
Rabbit. You be careful, Bobby.
All set for the night?
You mean the trial?
Yeah, no one's pulled out, have they?
Gotta be joking. They can't wait to get at Higgins. Let's face it, it's not every day you get a chance to get at one of the bastards that put you in here.
Yeah, well, just hang on a minute. The no violence rule still applies.
It does with me, Myra. Stop worrying, will you? It'll be okay.
I reckon all it needs is for this wire to be attached. Anyone got a screwdriver?
Well, didn't I say what I thought you'd come in useful one day?
Australia will soon admit.
That's good work, Mitchell. Proud of you. Just to make sure there's nothing dangerous, I better take this and check it over properly. Don't want any of my girls to get electrocuted, do I?
Chris, Phil. Yeah, look, is that offer for transport still open?
Sorry, there's...
Right, I need to ride home for 10 minutes so I can get a shave and a change of clothes. Right, no, you'll never make it past the gate guard, so I'll have to meet you out front.
Have your men...
No.
Well, they're not going to leave until they get some sort of statement, now, are they?
I'm sure the inspector's men can persuade.
By force? How's that going to look on the TV news tonight?
Yeah, Mrs. Barry's right. You can't confiscate all the radios and TVs on the outside. That sort of thing can only work in here.
Inspector, a call for you.
When that extortionist called me this morning, the first thing he stipulated was no police and no media. Well, obviously, I can't do anything about the police, but the media is another matter. I want them moved on using whatever means is necessary.
Right. Well, they traced that call back to a public phone box. Got a good set of prints. Confirms what I suspected. His name's Brian Lowe.
Hey, is he the lead you were talking about?
Yes, he is.
Good. Well, you can pick him up soon enough.
Yes. Yeah, well, it's not quite that simple. Yes, but it gives us somewhere to start.
She's on duty at the moment.
She's got a mother living in Fitzroy. Two of them are pretty close, so she might know something.
Hey, was her husband killed in a pub brawl?
Yeah, do you know?
Well, I know a Lowe in Fitzroy. She was on my list. Hazel Lowe, right?
Yeah, that's her. Well, we've talked to her, of course, but she insists she hasn't seen her son since he went into prison.
Well, he's not going to go back and visit his mother. I mean, he must know you'd be watching the place.
Well, not really, because he doesn't know we're on to. No, I think the real problem will be trying to get something out of his mother. Police aren't her favourite people.
Inspector, another call.
Right. Hey, Russ.
Look, I'm going home for a while. See you later.
Oh, right.
Look, well, you handle it.
We understand the staff of this prison are being held hostage following the shooting of three police officers
me,
last night. Is there any way to
release? Let me through.
Can you confirm the hostages are prison?
No comment.
Mr. Cleary, I was at the scene of the shooting. I believe you're a close friend
of
the
hell's ever done me? Look, I said no comment.
We don't expect women to survive.
Is there anything you'd like to say to the
kidnapper? No comment. I said no comment.
Those women must have known the risks of working in a prison. Do you think it's right that a large sum of tech...
Take it easy, mate. Don't let those bastards get to you.
Chris, I need your help.
Yeah, what?
I'm sick of waiting for the police to do something. I gotta leave. Will you help me?
Yeah. Pop in.
Okay. Meg. Meg, listen to me. You have to stay conscious. Talk to me. He's coming.
Just on my way past, but I checked that everything's... Smart. You two are too smart for your own good, aren't you?
We have to get her to a hospital. She's got a concussion.
Well, that's her fault. She shouldn't have tried to get smart with me. And neither should you. Just leave the bloody gags on. You take it off again, Screw, and I'll get nasty. There's no one to hear. Even if they did and they came in, they'd just blow themselves up and you along with them.
Would that worry you?
It wouldn't suit me, Screw. Not yet. Not till you've spoken to your boss.
You want me to speak to Colby?
Both of you. He wants to hear your lovely voices. So I better get him on tape while I still can.
What do you mean, while you can?
There you go again. You worry too much. I told you I wouldn't kill you, as long as they pay up. Don't you think I'm a man of my word, eh? Of course, I didn't say I wouldn't leave you here to blow yourselves up. I'll get blown up by the cops if they ever find a place. That's what I'd really like. To see a dozen or so cops blow themselves away with you. Then I won't be here to see it happen. Me and Mum and the dough will be long gone.
Could we at least have a drink before you go?
Sure. Help yourself.
Shouldn't have let him get to you like that. You're not still stewing on it, are you?
No, it's just what I needed, something to hit out at. I'm all right now.
Well, would you mind telling me where we're going?
Fitzroy. I want to pay a visit on a Mrs. Lowe.
No, I'm sorry, sir. No, we can't comment on that. You're fine. Well, I never thought I'd end up on a switchboard.
Oh, sorry, Len. I'd get someone to replace you, but I just haven't got the staff.
Oh, that's all right. It doesn't hurt any of us to do a bit extra.
Oh, I wish everyone felt that way. How much longer will you be there?
Well, Sue's on a coffee break at the moment, and then, hang on, here we go again.
Well, I got rid of those reports.
Hello. How did you manage that?
I promised them a full statement at headquarters at 6. Damn nuisance, but it'll keep Colby happy.
But Lowe said not to talk to the press.
No, it's got past that now, and he knows it. Now, the best thing is to put out our version and hope it gets reported accurately. Right, look, I'll be off now. If anything crops up while I'm gone, you just ring headquarters. They'll get me on the two-way.
Right. Oh, I'm glad you got rid of those reporters. At least I can get the women out into the grounds now.
Yeah, well, it's a start anyway. And given a couple of decent breaks, maybe we can get things back to normal for you before too long.
Oh, I hope so. You know, the funny thing about a crisis is the way everyone pulls together.
No, I'm sorry.
Gives you time to think how much responsibility you've got.
Just at the moment.
Oh, I wish Mrs. Reynolds was back.
Yeah, we'll just be with us for a while.
You're doing fine.
Thank you.
You're fine.
Slow down. Here's number 24 on the right.
Seven VKC.
Yes, seven.
Keeping surveillance on house in Parker Street. Car containing two men just pulled up. Neither fits suspect description. Driver remaining in car. Passenger moving to house. Instructions, please.
Stand by.
Looks a bit like one of those collection agency types. Probably come to repossess the budget.
It's not Meals on Wheels, that's for sure.
VKC 7, maintain surveillance, inspectors on his way.
Understood, VKC.
Do you think we'll have time for a game of softball, Miss Ferguson?
No, we've only got 15 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you're going to have to be quick if you want to catch a frog.
No worries, I'll have a backup ball in 5 minutes.
Oh, I don't think so, not unless it's been raining. Anyway, where's the bucket?
Well, I don't reckon it's fair. Just because there's some creep in isolation, why should we miss out on an exercise period?
So that was the reason.
What else could it be?
Can't keep anything from you, can we, Mitchell? Sharp as a tack.
I know.
Hope you're sorry to see me this time, Mum. Bryony's brought home the goodies. $250,000. Easy Street, Mum. Easy Street.
A report from police headquarters says the governor of Wentworth Detention Centre has been abducted.
Bastards!
Details.
Told you to keep it quiet, you lying bastards!
Who are they trying to keep?
Come on, Rousey. Where are you? I don't like the feel of this.
Me either.
Golly, Myra. You're a million miles away then, weren't you?
I wish I was. Now, I'm just wondering. I reckon there's more going on here than we think.
What do you mean?
Did you see the look on the freak's face when we blamed all this on isolation? It seemed to strike her as being very funny.
Well, what do you think it could be then?
I wish I knew.
Ow! Just hear someone. I heard it.
Oh, better not be another bloody snake. That's all I can say.
Yeah, snakes don't go ribbit. Here he is. Come on, you little mongrel.
Oh, God.
You've got to talk to it.
I was talking to it.
In frog language, stupid.
What are you talking about?
Look, I read it in a magazine. They reckon if you're barking me out, your dogs and your cats, they take more notice of you. It's the same with frogs.
Are you having me on?
Try it. Well, go on.
There he is.
Ribbit. Oh. You got to say it like you mean it.
Hello.
Gotcha. Come on. It's all right. See you, boy. Hello.
Ribbit.
Hi, Miss Ferguson. Look what I've got.
Suppose you're going to take it to your cell and hope it turns into a handsome prince, eh?
Oh, no. I'm just going to look at it.
Get rid of it.
Oh, Miss Ferguson.
Get rid of it, Warren. I'm warning you.
No, Mr. Cleary. Always thought you was fair dinkum. Don't know who to trust anymore. Fancy telling a mother something like that. You're just like them bloody coppers.
Mrs. Lowe, please. I'm not trying to hassle you. I just want to find Brian so that I can talk to him.
Well, you can't. Brian wouldn't do that. He wouldn't.
Then help me talk to him and we can clear up this misunderstanding.
Don't you think he's been through enough? He done time for something he didn't do. Then when he gets out, I had to tell him about Phyllis. Poor kid. You leave him alone.
So, Lo, I'm begging you. I've got to talk to him. And quickly, or it's going to be too late.
God, I'm thirsty. And, we'll just have to wait till he gets back. If he gets back. He has to have proof that we're still alive before he can collect the money. He'll be back.
What if someone comes first and gets tangled in one of the tripwires?
We just have to hope they don't.
His debt to society. Why can't you mongrels leave him alone to get on with his life?
Does he have access to a flat or something? Some place we could take two people without anyone knowing?
You're still saying he done it, aren't you? Oh, I'm wasting me bloody time talking to you. Listen, as much as I love him, I'm the first to admit he's a lazy little bugger. He couldn't be bothered. He can hardly get out of bed in the mornings. Why would he do it anyway? He doesn't need the money. He's just as happy to stand in line for the doll every week.
If you believe that, if you really believe that, then you've been going through life with your eyes closed. You have to face reality.
Don't say that to her.
Brian!
Nobody talks to Mum like that. Nobody.
Where have you been, love? I've been awfully worried about you.
I'm all right, Mum. I can take care of myself. Who says I can't get out of bed, eh? I did it, Mum.
What?
What do you say? I kidnapped them two women. I thought it all out myself, Mum. I want you to go and unpack a bag because we're going away.
Ryan, you're not serious.
Where are they, Lou?
Shut up.
Tally, damn it, Tally!
Around.
Ryan!
Get off! Sorry, Mum.
Ryan! Oh, God!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are Christmas too. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses. When morning comes around.